Hey everybody, Sadine Piat here from Healthy You, Healthy Love, and I am the coach for smart, savvy women looking for intimate, sexy love. If you haven't yet, please subscribe and click that bell button to get notified of my next video. Also, please do share this video if you like what I'm about to share, and I want to hear from you. I want to hear your thoughts on this video, so please do comment below as well. So today's video is all about understanding a little bit of a sneaky dynamic when it comes to rejection. There is this saying called rejection breeds obsession. So this video today is for women who are actually out there dating in the dating world. This is not so much for women who are fearful of dating and fearful of being rejected. There are plenty of women who don't date at all because they're so scared of being rejected. They're so scared of feeling less in any way. They already don't feel that good about themselves, and they're fearful that if they date, they'll feel even worse and they can't handle and even process rejection. It feels too painful, too revealing, too exposing on a number of different levels. So perhaps I'll do another video for those women in that category, but today's video is for women who are dating. For example, you've dated a guy, you like him, things are going pretty well, he seems nice, but you're just not that interested. You haven't been overly encouraging towards him. You've not really reached out to him much. You've always waited for him to contact you. So encouragement for him is low. And then as time goes by, he kind of like puts his foot down on some level. He says to you, hey, if you're not interested, I'm not interested. I've actually, going to move on. I've met somebody else. Or they don't say anything like that. That's not their situation. They have just pulled away from you or completely stopped contacting you. And this is what happens a lot in the dating world. Rejection breeds obsession. As soon as you feel like someone is pulled away, as soon as you're starting to feel rejected, all of a sudden you become more interested in the guy. This is particularly unhelpful when the guy really isn't good for you, but you only like him more because you're feeling rejected by him. It's a scarcity game. That's probably something that's happened in your childhood that has you hooking in to men who reject you. Sometimes it's hot and cold rejections. Sometimes warm, sometimes not. But it can often be with a guy that you're not really that keen on, but as soon as he pulls away or as soon as he says he's moving on, you want him more. Now, this is helpful with someone who legitimately is good for you, because maybe you were being a bit complacent. You weren't treating him all that well. You weren't encouraging. And now that he's pulled away, the obsession has started to show and you actually do legitimately like him. That's a beautiful thing. Sometimes when something seems too easy, we can sometimes not value it. And I'd love that to not be the case. And I think the more evolved the woman is, the less that happens, the more evolved we are. When we see something that really is amazing for us, we do, and we're more likely to act on it and actually encourage it from the get-go. However, we're complex and sometimes things are happening where, we're blocked and we're fearful, or the guy isn't as perfect as we would like him to be in some way, whether it's superficially with clothes and what he wears, or whether it's the job he has, or whether it's what he looks like. He's not as sexy or as fit as you were hoping. And so that digital dating cycle of the grass is greener syndrome has actually taken over your ability to see how amazing he is until you started to experience that rejection breeds obsession kind of experience, where you started to feel like you're going to miss out on him, and then the clarity came to you. So that's great. All you need to do, they said, let the guy know that you actually do really like him and see what he does, and even share with him that you were fearful or that it seemed too easy, and now you realize that you actually really do value him and would like to pursue something and see if there's any real legs and compatibility in there for something more serious. However, I don't want you getting hooked on men who pull away and you only like them and you become obsessed with them because of this push-pull feeling. This is not healthy. I've been in unhealthy relationships. I've been with people who aren't great and healthy for me. And I know this feeling that rejection breeds obsession. So in this video today, I want you to be empowered in dating. I want you to be investing in men that are healthy for you, that are compatible for you, and that are ready for commitment. Because not every man that you are somewhat compatible with is able to commit, right? And you've got to ask yourself too, are you able to commit. So if you can take anything away from you today, is that I don't want you obsessed with men that aren't healthy for you. If that feeling of rejection allowed you to really see the light that this guy's awesome, then let him know. Other than that, let it go. Let your ego, it's an ego game when you get obsessed with a man who's only rejecting you, and the only time you sort of really start wanting him is when he's walking away and then it's hot and cold and he's not that kind to you, and it's a real sort of, you know, not an easy thing for you. It's not an easy flowing kind of kind relationship. I don't want you obsessed with those guys. So let it go. And also, if there is a guy that you do legitimately like and he seems like an awesome guy and he does pull away and you do feel that sense of rejection and you do share with him that you like him and he no longer is willing to invest, then that's okay too. We've got to get over our egos to find love. We've got to put ourselves out there a little bit in order to actually create what we want. So don't get caught in the rejection obsession loop. Start dating and being clear about what you really value. And that's it for this video. So please do share, comment, subscribe, click that notification button so that you do get my future videos. Check out my program, Never Lose Him. And I also have a fabulous free gift for you. I have this amazing quiz that's all about the four most common love blocks, which I call the romantic love syndromes that women have that can stop them from finding love. We have lots of different stories and beliefs from our past relationships, from even from our childhood, that can really block our ability to attract love and encourage really great men in our lives that we meet. So please check that link. Those links are right below in the description. And I look forward to seeing you at my next video. Keep dating, keep showing up, and get over that fear of rejection and encourage the right men. Lots of love. See you soon.